We're live at the Great Falls Balloon Festival. The Saturday morning, 6 a.m. launch got scrapped. They waited now until 9. They're inflating a couple of the shape balloons. This is Peanut, the elephant. It's just going to inflate. It's not going to go up. As is the Tomcat balloon, which you see in the distance there, the back of his head. So they're just inflating. They're not going up this morning. It's a bit too windy for these big shape balloons to go up, so. But they wanted to inflate to allow people to actually see them fully blown up here. We'll walk around this guy and see how big it is. This is the largest of the balloons here this weekend. And of course, every year they always bring in a few shape balloons.
Most elephants do look like horses.
Well, no, I think it's that.
SunJournal.com. We have a bunch of photos, videos, including drone video of yesterday's launch and 360 video of yesterday's launch. It's all at SunJournal.com.
So is that full now, or are you waiting to take off?
Sometimes the organizer asks him to leave it on the ground so the crowd.
Sorry if we were disconnected there. I was talking to the woman who owns the balloon. She was saying that if you miss this, that they will come back and inflate tonight, this evening at 6. But sometimes festival organizers ask that the balloon just stays on the ground so people can see it. And taking off and landing somewhere else. And also she said a balloon this size, you need extra large landing space. So a lot more area you would need to take to land this guy than a normal average size hot air balloon. So if you're not able to get down here now, if you come down this evening around 6, and if the wind cooperates, you should be able to see it inflate again. When I got over by the basket, I was starting to lose the Wi-Fi connection, so I don't want to go too far. And cell service is tough right now in the field with so many people uploading photos and videos to their social media, so. little too close. I can pull back and get a wide shot of it. See the whole balloon, and I have better Wi-Fi again, so I'll probably hang out just back here a little bit longer, so you can check it out. To fly, but you know, that doesn't always happen when it's playing. As you probably know, the weather moon, you can never really predict it. It was last night at 4, it was in the 60s yesterday. It's supposed to get hot and humid the rest of this weekend, and by Tuesday in the 90s with humidity, so it changes from 60s and cool and rain to 90s and humidity the next day. If you missed it earlier, we have lots of video, photos, and quite a bit of the festival at sunjournal.com and our balloon festival page, sunjournal.com/balloonfest. We have all kinds of great video from yesterday's launch, including our drone footage from the sky of yesterday's launch, as well as 360 video from the field. So you can kind of spin all around and check out what a launch would look like if you were standing in the middle of the field during it. As well as great photography from our photographers and contributors. And even some readers submitted photos. So if you have any great photos from the festival, you can send them to us. Post them in the comment section below. Post them to our Facebook page. You can tweet at us at Sun Journal. Also, just to let you guys know that we are also on Instagram at Sun Journal and on Snapchat, The Sun Journal. So just add us, and we're adding Snap stories all weekend from the festival grounds. And just a note, there's a stage here, so there's bands that play, there's plenty of music, and there's vendors that are selling goods throughout the day. Today there's a parade at 11. It starts over by the old Great Falls School, or well, now the Community Little Theater in Auburn, and it goes down Main Street in Auburn, across the bridge, and down Lincoln Street in Lewiston, ending back at the festival grounds at Smart Main Park. And it looks like the elephant's going to go down. I think it's getting a little too windy for it. So it was up for a good 15-20 minutes or so.
That's a wait.
So if you missed this, I was talking to one of the balloonists from Peanut here, the elephant balloon, and she told me that they will be back this evening. They're going to inflate. Now, whether or not they go up, that's dependent upon the balloon organizers. Sometimes they request these shaped balloons to stay on the ground so people can see them. But sometimes they go up in the air. I mean, we've seen shapes go up in the air, I think, every year since the festival's been having them. So, though we didn't have launch this morning, we did have partial launch. We had inflation. But the good kind of inflation. Deborah, the balloons are not going up, they just inflated so people can see them, take photos with them. But that's it. We've been told by the festival that none of the balloons are going up. There'll be no launch, just a couple of the shaped balloons inflated so people could see them and take photos with them. I think wind was probably still a bit of a factor going up. I know there's a cloud cover. It's not too bad. I was talking to the balloon mice earlier, and he was saying that we need 1,500 feet of a roof of cloud cover, then 3,000 feet of visibility to be able to go up. So that, then the field was wet. So as you can see, the tarp is down. We'll lay out the balloons, but that also, I think, plays a factor in it, is how wet the field is. And it rained pretty hard last night across Lewiston Auburn. So the field was still pretty damp this morning. Peanut, the elephant, goes down. Tomcat is deflated. I think Terry's going to inflate. That's the mouse. Over there, so we'll go out. Over the
between the wind and the noise. Blowing up the balloons and trying to talk as loud as I can, but it's not exactly the ideal conditions. Selling food, is a souvenir food, or t-shirts, hats, and the like.
Yeah,
on the backside, that's where we're broadcasting from, the Sunburn booth, where me and camera is. As well as some more food and corporate blankies on this side, as well as porta potties. There's only like vendors on the backside of the booth. There you can check out. Kathy and Roland, no, they are not going up. They are only in Cleveland.
So, also, we may have, I don't think we're going to get around to the other side of the balloons. Our wireless connection won't reach over there, I don't think. Sorry. I know. So you will should check with us.
Well, if you're watching this feed, I'm going to go ahead and end it, but we're still live on our Facebook page, so just go to our Facebook page and you'll see our live feed. I'm going to go out and get some photos and update our Instagram at Sun Journal, Twitter at Sun Journal, and Snapchat the Sun Journal. And don't forget, you can see all of our coverage at sunjournal.com. We have a lot of video, photos from yesterday's launch, including our exclusive drone footage from yesterday's launch, as well as a 360 camera. So if you want to experience what it's like, be right down in the middle of the field during the launch. You can check that out. It's all on sunjournal.com. Thanks, guys, for joining us.